So here we're looking at a male specimen. We notice the kidney is still retroperitoneal here. Just caudal to the kidney, we're going to have the testicular artery coming off. So the testicular artery and vein are coursing caudally through here, joining the ductus deferens with the deferential artery and vein, and then heading into the inguinal canal. Okay, so they're making up the spermatic cord, which we can see here. Notice we have a strip of muscle coming off the caudal edge of the internal abdominal oblique. That strip of muscle coming down, here's the cremaster muscle. Okay, so over on this side I have transected through the parietal vaginal tunic here. Notice we have our mesorchium here, our mesofunniculus here, because we have our testicular vessels suspended from the mesorchium. But then here our ductus deferens has its own mesentery, the mesoductus deferens. And then our common mesentery here is the mesofunniculus. Okay, so our pampiniform plexus doesn't look like it got injected real well here, but it's up at the head of the epididymis. We can see the head here, the body, and the tail of the epididymis. At the tail of the epididymis, we have the proper ligament of the testes, and then we have the ligament of the tail of the epididymis here. Now, these are remnants of the gubernaculum. So that is our testis and its mesenteries. Okay, so here is the urinary bladder once again with the median ligament. And we see here, down here at the neck, we have a very large prostate gland. And if we just cut that prostate gland right down through here, so here now we can see the urethra opened up a crest here, and there's a enlargement right here. That's the colliculus seminalis. On either side of that, the ductus deferens empty into the urethra. So remember, the prostate gland is important for alkalinizing or deacidifying the ejaculate so that the sperm have better motility. It also adds a protein that promotes capacitation. Okay. Okay, now let's have a look at the penis. Now notice within the prepuce here, it does have room to expand outward. Okay. So we're going to follow it up here. It's going to be a little bit difficult to visualize. Okay. So we have here the root of the penis here coming out. Coming off the tuber ischii is going to be the ischiocavernosus muscle. Remember, it's covering over the corpus cavernosum. And then here we have the bulbospongiosus muscle. And then the much paler retractor penis muscle. Okay, so we're going to make an incision up here. We're going to make an incision down here on the body. We'll make an incision here through the bulbus glandis, and then we'll make an incision here on the pars longa glandis. Okay, okay, so we made this incision way up here at the root. We can see the two crus of the penis coming together, surrounded by the ischiocavernosus muscle. We have the urethra right here, surrounded by the corpus spongiosum. And then this muscle here is the bulbospongiosus muscle. If we come on down to this segment, I did not cut through the retractor penis muscle here. But we can see here the corpus cavernosum, the urethra surrounded by the corpus spongiosum, Remember, we have this white connective tissue layer here, the tunica albuginea. Okay, so once again, there's the retractor penis muscle there. We come down here to the bulb of the penis. So I had to cut through the os penis here. There's the urethra, surrounded by a little bit of corpus spongiosum, which is then continuous with the bulbus glandis. And then finally here at our pars longa glandis, once again, we still have a little bit of the os penis. The urethra is here surrounded by corpus spongiosum. And then we have the pars longa glandis cavernous tissue. Okay. So there we go. So that's the male reproductive system.